Ladies and gentlemen, they'll never stop, Joe. Ladies and gentlemen, Joe Johnson from Bradford, snooker champion of the world. Joe, I think I might applaud you all night, but it's been quite an interesting day, hasn't it?
Certainly has. Yeah, terrific, yeah. Brilliant. I'd like to say a few words about Steve. I know that everybody will be at me because I'm a Yorkshireman, but I mean, what a terrific player Steve is, and I don't think that the people give him the recognition that he should have. I mean, he's a terrific sportsman. His ability is second to none, and is the perfect gentleman in snooker and out of snooker. Great ambassador. And I hope that we can still be friends.
Were there any moments tonight? I mean, you said to me before, you came out and spoke to me with a mug of tea in your hand. You said you're going to bring that out. Were there any moments tonight you said, I don't worry, I'm going to have fun? Was it fun?
It was fun, yeah. It was terrific playing Steve. I learnt a lot just playing him. You know, I really did. I learnt a lot. I learnt how to keep cool, and his position is something else, and I just tried to make my position play as good as what Steve's were. And I had all the running, of course. Oh, yes.
You did actually go for a few pots as well, didn't you?
Yeah. Well, if you go for the pots, you sometimes you leave the balls and sometimes you get away with it. I got away with it today.
Getting away with it is a man who describes a championship of the world. Can I bring in... You've heard the tribute that Joe Johnson has paid to him, and I think, once again, it's hard to lose here tonight, isn't it?
Well, we can't really go on meeting like this, can we, David? No. No, I've got... it's a funny feeling, actually. This is my second time talking to you this situation.
And that's twice as much as you said last year.
But today I got absolutely buried, and I've got absolutely no complaints, and Joe's played... fantastic, and he's a worthy champion.
I don't think there's anything more to be said than that. We've watched a wonderful snooker final here. They've said it all, I think, so it's down now to the business of the pots and the checks. So let me welcome in the presentation party that's led by the chairman of the governing body, Mr. Rex Williams, with Mr. Brian Ray, director of Imperial Tobacco Limited, Mr. Peter Dyke, head of the sponsored events, and Mr. Paul Hather, the tournament director. First of all, gentlemen... Steve... there is something. First of all, to the runner-up, Mr. Steve Davis, not just the runners-up check for £42,000, but also, of course, the high-break champion again this year, for which he gets another little matter of £7,000, and the pot black trophy. The runner-up, Steve Davis. To a man from Bradford who hated the television lights. He seems to like them now because from Bradford, Joe Johnson with the trophy and a check for £70,000. Joe Johnson, champion of the world. So that's tonight here at the Crucible. Joe Johnson, the 1986 Embassy World Professional Champion, and his wife in tears, and who wouldn't be, and they'll probably keep applauding all night if I didn't interrupt you. But as I say, that's the end of another great championship here. Not quite the end of our night, because just in case you missed it, and you really have missed something special, we'll be back here at 11:40 on BBC Two with the story of the championship. But let me leave you here at the Crucible with the man who is the new champion, and what a welcome champion he is, Joe Johnson.
Joe, play this world. 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 Jo